So, you've booted up Zelda Breath of the Wild in Cemu, and you've been scanning Amiibo ad nauseum thanks to the Complaining Gamer's tutorial on infinite Amiibo scans, and you still can't get an entire Fierce Deity clothing set, that double blade helix sword, or even get a Pona to spawn. Frustrating! There are a couple different methods you can use, but I'm going to share with you the easiest solution that I've found so far to fill up your inventory with the rarest clothing, weapons, shields, and even rare horses like Epona that you can only obtain via Amiibo. As we all know, the rare loot like this all come from scanning various Zelda-related Amiibos, and the Complaining Gamer has an excellent tutorial on how to bypass the one Amiibo scan per day limit. This is pretty cool to up some common items in your inventory without doing a lot of running around the forest gathering, and in theory, this should work to get your rare loot as well via the chest drops. However, even with the unlimited Amiibo scans, I found that I was wasting an insane amount of time scanning NFC Amiibo files. I still only picked up a couple rare items after scanning for a very long time. The drop rate for these items is incredibly low, so here's how to save your time and get the rare loot that you're craving right now. I'm going to show you how to use Mark Robledo's HTML5 save game editor to get the rare loot that you're after. But first, a short disclaimer. I highly advise against using this to cheat in the game. Zelda Breath of the Wild is an amazing experience, and I hope that you gave yourself the opportunity to play it in the way that the devs intended. With that being said, there's obviously a little room to save our sanity here. No one is going to want to scan Amiibo all day just to get some rare loot that can only be obtained via Amiibo. So this is what you have to do. Go to the save game directory for Zelda Breath of the Wild. You'll know that you're in the right directory because the number will match the directory number that is present on the Cemu title bar when you're running the game. Select the first save game slot folder. Here you'll see a file called gamedata.save. That's game, G-A-M-E, underscore, data, D-A-T-A, dot save, S-A-V. Copy this file elsewhere. This is the version that we'll be using to make our edits on. I highly suggest that you make copies of all files that you edit, just in case something goes wrong. You don't want to mess up your save game file by mistake. Now upload this file to the HTML5 save game editor. Edit. This is the interesting part. This is where you get to go through all of the items in the game. You can add pretty much anything you want into your save game file with this tool. But I'm only using it to obtain rare loot that can only be obtained with Amiibo. You can play the game as you wish, of course, and use this tool to add whatever you'd like, but personally, I only use it for rare weapons, equipment, and to obtain Epona. Once you're done making the changes to your save game file, scroll back up to the top and save your game. Put this newly generated save game file back into your Cemu save game directory and then boot your game. And the last step, of course, is profit. Check out your new rare loot. And it's really as simple as that. No more scanning Amiibo ad nauseum. You can now travel Hyrule with all that rare Amiibo exclusive swag. If this video helped you, then please give it a like and share it with a friend. Consider subscribing to the Regenerate channel and join the community over in the Regenerate Discord server. The link is in the description. We have a small but growing community of amazing people, and we'd love to have you join us there. Until next time, have fun, game on, and remember, don't forget to smile.